Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. You're watching the national final of Tata Crucible for campuses across India. And 10 teams battling for the first time. And it's a first look at where the teams stand on what we call the Crucible Exchange. Here it comes. We move to the second frontier, and this will only get better and tense as the scores keep progressing. For now, it's time for us to play the second frontier, NFS. Here it comes. Need for strategy on your screens. The idea behind this year's Tata Crucible was to create a platform where these youngsters experience what they're going to be doing in the future, which is take decisions, play the game with a lot of strategy. It's also a measure and an index of how much we trust ourselves, especially when it comes to areas like knowledge. This round, perhaps in many ways, exemplifies that. The base value of a question is 50 crubits. If you think you're reasonably okay with your answer, you can up that to a booster at 75. If you're super confident, play a multiplier, which makes it 100. The negative is what you lose, and you get what you choose. There's another strategy tool called a mine, which can only be played by a team that plays the first option, or the first attempt, where, if you're not sure, you play at a base value, and you reserve the right to choose from the remaining 9 teams who will answer after you. If they get it right, your negative gets reduced by half and they get a 50 for getting it right. The logic is, in life, on numerous occasions, we're not going to know the answers. But a prudent one in an organization or in any environment is the one who knows who to go to for possibly the right answers. So picking on people who could know the right answers is good strategy in the modern world. If you're ready, you know the rules of the game. 2 attempts on every question, hands on the buzzer, starting with the first one, coming up now. Tata Trusts, along with a global aerospace major, are working on an India Innovation Growth Program. Ashoka University on my far right, what do you make of it and what's your strategy?
Multiply.
That's a 100.
Yes.
Go on.
Lockheed Martin.
Lockheed Martin,
yes.
And the Tatas.
Yes.
100. 100! Ashoka University hedging and hedging big on that. You need a lot of courage at a national final to play 100, and they seemed very confident. They went for a high pitch, 100 to Ashoka University. Here's the next one. Overall answer is what matters. Careful. Here it comes.
Isn't it beautiful?
Jamshedpur are off in a flash. What's your strategy?
We are taking normal, 50.
Sorry?
50.
Base value? Alright.
Is this HDFC?
Explain.
That's Hasmukh Bhai Parekh. He was the founder of HDFC Bank. And I'm like, that's the only
that's an ad, I believe, of savings and for home loans. The guy is saving some money, so we're going with that drift.
There's another very famous logo below that. Let truth prevail.
That's the Times Group, Bennett and Goldman.
Times Group, okay.
So, but the
overall Times Group.
No idea, sir. HDFC, I'm guessing.
At a point in time, the Times of India Group also had a bank called Times Bank, which later became part of HDFC. Put your hands together for them. HDFC will get a 50. As we go to the next one, on your screen, here it comes. The year was 1925. John Oxford Robinson, from the equally old and famous Spencer Corporation at the time, decided to buy the Madras Mail and a bookstore. Which bookstore has been shifting hands for many decades? IIM Indore. From the Madras Mail to a bookstore, the Spencers were one of the biggest buyers in those days.
We'll go for a mine.
You go for a mine.
Is this Higginbottoms?
Higginbottoms. Fantastic. Oh, very well played. He gets himself the 50, but he really wasn't sure on it. As we go to the next one, on your screens, here it comes. What was this called? Apollo insurance cover. Suratkal, okay?
We'll go with
strategy.
75. Plus 25.
Both engineers?
Yeah, so...
When you disagree, take a middle path.
So what happened was, during the Apollo mission, they were not sure whether they'll come back or not. So they signed on these papers, if they don't come back, they'll sell this. Their family could sell this and they could like live off that cash. So these are those papers signed by...
some sort of insurance, like if they don't come back from the moon, if it's a failed mission, they can sell this and live off the money.
Why would they not insure themselves?
This was like provided from NASA itself to those scientists. Because this was the first time someone is going...
You're saying this was like insurance. It was created in case they don't come back to sell it and for the families to make money out of it.
Yeah, something like...
The reality is, sometimes adventure is taken with skepticism. Human ventures are taken with a pinch of salt. No insurance company was willing to cover these astronauts. Hence, they came up with this idea to have memorabilia signed by them, which will be sold in case they did not return. Thankfully, it became collectibles and not an insurance relief. Put your hands together. 75. Fantastic. Here's the next one on your screens. Here we go. This man... on my right, Silchar, this man is now called Swaran Singh by the media. Why?
100.
Yeah, go on. 100.
Basically,
you're playing a multiplier. 100 NIT Silchar, okay?
His name is Sampuran Singh. So the thing is that Indian Railways took his land to build rail lines through it. But then they didn't compensate it. And so I think there was a court case and he was awarded 1.67 crore rupees. So, and Indian Railway still didn't compensate him. Then the court decided that he will be given the ownership of Swarn Shatabdi Express. And so he became Swarn.
This farmer's land was taken by the government. The compensation did not reach him. He went back to the court and the court said, till the railways pay you the compensation, you will own the Swarn Shatabdi Express. Put your hands together. 100! As we go to the next one, team's hands on the buzzer, the battle's getting tight. And here's the next one coming on your screen now. They've gone for it in a flash. St. Stephen's are off in a flash.
Multiplier, 100.
Multiplier for 100, says St. Stephen.
Yeah, this was the method which was used by one of the places in Kerala to subdue the 500 meter rule. So basically, the Supreme Court pronounced the judgment that shops which lie within 500 meters cannot sell alcohol. So in order to prevent, circumvent that rule, they made this maze so that the distance between the highway and the alcohol shop is more than 500 meters.
100 to St. Stephen.
Next week, the action comes to a grand conclusion as one team out of 10 will define the champions in the national finals.